Unis theory is a mathematical theory for optimal health in biological systems. All biological systems are classified mathematically as complex, nonlinear manifolds. All protoplasm is classified physicochemically as a colloid, a quasi-state between solid and liquid, a special complex solution that does not precipitate, but remains dissolved across a spectrum of energy states. The protoplasm's components nonlinearly amplify narrow bands of energies in the biomolecules. This is what gives biological gels their amazing properties. They can take advantage of narrow bands of energy in the environment and channel it by amplifying it nonlinearly. As a channel for energy, it forms a manifold. Manifold is a term from topology, the mathematics of shapes and surfaces, that describes a channel for energy. As channels for energy that non-linearly amplify energy, all biological systems are complex energy forms. They are literally colloidal manifolds of energy flows. The biomolecules of the system constrain the energy, limiting the freedom of the molecules to be completely random. They literally order the flow of energy by this constraint. As the energy flows, it becomes interwoven into complex patterns, or enfolded. These enfoldings of the energy flows form complex patterns of sol-gel relations. Some portions of these flow patterns are liquid, and some are solid, and some are even gaseous, as in the lungs. Each describes a phase space, or volume of molecules of similar sol-gel phase. These form what are called percolation clusters of fractal informs that are interwoven on all levels. Hence, the enfoldment of these energy flows involve multiple interwoven phase spaces. As molecules pass through this flux of energy, they are described mathematically as variables in the system. As variables in the equation of the system, each perturbs the energy flow, changing it by participating with it. As a component of the flux, each increases the tendency of the system to change, increasing the system's criticality. When the variables entering the system fit the channels of flow, they are said to fit the base algorithm of the system. When the variables fit this base algorithm or pattern of flow, all is well. The system is designed to handle these variables, and the integrity of the pattern is preserved. It remains integrated. When a variable enters the system that does not fit the space algorithm, it becomes an energy the system must contend with, but which does not participate with the system. Such variables cannot be integrated into the system and become what are called independent variables. These independent variables disintegrate the system. They compete with the information in the base algorithm for control of system energy flow rather than becoming part of it. They function as separate systems of information in the pattern. Their presence shift the flow of energy and distort the normal pattern. Since one algorithm is no longer controlling the system, it is literally disintegrated, no longer one pattern of energy. Normal flow patterns are distorted or lost altogether. Catastrophic, nonlinear shifts of the system can occur, splitting the energy flow from the one directed by the base algorithm. So-called catastrophic bifurcations emerge. In a biological mathematical context, point attractors distort function and dysfunction, their presence, threatens to become a persistent abnormal pattern in the equation, disease. Dysfunction becomes disease as point attraction becomes critical and nonlinear catastrophic changes result. As point attraction increases, systems lose dimensionality and responses of the system become more and more limited. Normal interdependence of the subsystems decreases until it is lost altogether and the system struggles to maintain integrity of the flow. As long as flow continues, the system is intact and persists across time. This changing, evolving flow of molecules must remain intact for the organism to persist as an energy form. Persistence of this flow is what we call life. Gradually, stressors from normal flow tax these point attractor-dominated limited subsystems, reducing the probability the system can maintain the flow. Loss of adaptability of responses reflects loss of freedom in these energy flows from the point attractor set build up. The system is no longer as flexible and resilient in the face of changes. The criticality increase has limited its ability to absorb more stressors, and the system is said to be weakened. As point attraction in the tissues builds up more and more, tissue loses its ability to respond to this flux and participate in normal metabolic flow. The subsystems of energy flow literally clog up. Eventually, energy flow becomes severely compromised. Criticality has reached the point where almost any perturbation will disintegrate the system and evoke a catastrophic, nonlinear shift that shuts down the energy flow altogether and stops the flow of molecules through the system. The system closes as it ceases to temporally evolve. It ends or dies. In any dynamical biological system, unity is the normal integrated state reflecting that the system exists. It is configured in such a way that it can continue to flow with the energies impacting upon it as reflected in its structure. And its flows remain linear across time, or integrated, or connected across time. The biological system exists in the universe, reflecting its unity with the space-time continuum at that point. The integrity of this energy form is reflected in the fact that it is configured in such a way that it remains able to integrate the flows of energy or evolve across time in a way that connects each state to the next. This unity of the process with the universal space-time continuum is called in mathematics numerical integration. It literally means one with time. Another way of looking at this is likened to how we describe the motion of an object by position, when time is not changing, velocity, when we consider how it is moving at a given moment, and acceleration, when we consider how its velocity is changing at a given moment. In dynamical biological systems that exist as energy forms and remain intact across time, there would be similar derivations in unity, integrity, and integration. For unity to exist, the form must maintain integrity and must integrate. To integrate, it must maintain strange attraction. As a complex fractalin, nonlinear manifold of energy, it must continue to temporally evolve. To do that, point attraction cannot build up too much, where it will glue the energy form of the system to the wall of the space-time continuum and close it. We describe these three states in osteopathy with the three basic osteopathic principles. The body is a unit. Structure and function are interrelated. Structural order reflecting integrity of functional states. And the body inherently heals itself or integrates its stressors. The point attractors remain trivial and do not permanently distort the system to the point that it is catastrophically bifurcates and ends. The point attractor load keeps criticality below the catastrophic bifurcation level and continues to reverse point attraction and restore strange attraction. The body heals itself by keeping the stressors integral to the equation of the system. This gets to some pretty basic math, physics, and philosophy. For a biological system to persist, it must be. It must exist, reflecting unity with the space-time continuum and the universe. Its configuration must be such that it is ordered in the face of the entropy about it. The structure and function are related in such a way that the system is healthy and able to adapt to stressors coming in. It must continue to flow across time or evolve, preserving this unity with the space-time continuum by what mathematicians call numerical integration. In a biological context, numerical integration reflects that the basic equation of the system, its base algorithm, is intact. Variables passing through evoke responses it can handle and that integrate with the base algorithm and are integral to it. This numerical integration mathematically describes how the organism interacts with stressors. It describes the sum of the basic algorithm with all the dependent variables and the independent variables acting on the system. Attraction describes how these variables pull each derivation to the next. Normal metabolism reflects strange attraction dominance. Stressors reflect point attraction in the system. Strange attractors are optimal because they define fractals that are open-ended and do not close across time. These strange attractor dominant fractals temporally evolve or live. Strange attraction reflects the operations of dependent variables that are integral with the base algorithm of the system. Point attractors, if they are trivial, remain potentially integratable or integral to the system. Point attractors are normally passed through or eliminated from the system. If a point attractor is non-trivial, it becomes a second information system in the energy flow and threatens to permanently warp the flow of energy. Non-trivial point attractors, NTPAs, disintegrate the base algorithm and cannot, by definition, be integrated with the system. Both non-trivial and trivial point attractors reduce the freedom of the system as they tie up energy flows, reducing their freedom, limiting their responsibility, lowering the number of dimensionalities, and increasing the tendency of the system to change, its criticality. The lower the dimensionality, the fewer options the system has for adaptation to changes, and the greater the risk of a catastrophic bifurcation collapsing the system. Point attractor buildup is what causes this limitation, as point attraction in a dimensionality prevents normal strange attraction to operate in that dimensionality as long as the point attractor effects persist. The higher the dimensionality, the more strange attraction is operating in the system, and the greater the adaptability of the system, the greater the freedoms available for response patterns, and the fewer point attractors are dominating the system. Unisa theory defines optimal health mathematically as U for unity, Ni for numerical integration, and S for strange attraction. All biological systems are dynamical, and these same principles apply to all biological systems. All must exhibit unity, or they simply do not exist. Unity means one with the space-time continuum, existence itself. Numerical integration describes how unity and integrity keep energy flows integral to the base algorithm of the system. As long as variables are truly integral, they are dependent. Independent variables passing through the system pose the risk of non-trivial point attraction, irreversible change that can cause the organism, as an energy form, to stick to the wall of the space-time continuum. Non-trivial point attraction is death. Strange attraction, the opposite of point attraction, allows the fractal and flows of the system to continue, to persist across time. Strange attraction is a property of dynamical systems that is essential for such systems to persist. For such energy flows to progress as a series of steady states, unity, integrity, numerical integration, and strange attraction must all remain properties of the system. Otherwise, as a nonlinear colloidal manifold of energy flow, it would not exist.